I love the metaphor. If you walk into an absolute darkness is like a cave that has no light, and
yes,
you can't even see your hand.
You can't see your hand, yeah.
It's, if you've ever been in that kind of setting, imagine that. You walk into that room, and you're in the room, and you look. You see nothing. So based on your perception, your experience, there's nothing there.
Yeah.
But what happens when you turn on the light? There's so many things there, but there was nothing there. How did so many things all of a sudden miraculously appear? What happened to the darkness? I would suggest that the darkness doesn't go anywhere. It coexists with the light. The light actually embraces it fully as a part of itself. And we don't see the darkness anymore. Because we're designed, I believe, to be in this body to experience joy. And in order to know what joy is, we experience the contrast that's existing all the time in our lives when we're out of alignment with that joy or with that love and that true beingness. Everyone, I think, is born this way. The disruptive piece that I had to interject was the idea that I was separate, is the idea that I was not connected. When you feel that oneness, you aren't worried about something. You aren't stressed about this or processing whether you should or shouldn't do this. Or you're not in conflict. You're in a flow.
Yeah.
We're here to embrace the moment we're in, to challenge the beliefs that we have that are being used to project the images that we've made up from those beliefs on the experience we're having. And when I challenge that, now it's like turning on the light. Now the light illuminates what appears to be the darkness. And now I can see all the objects in the room.
Yeah.
But before that, I couldn't see anything.